Okay, good morning students. So today I'll be taking you for your poem which is in class 10th, written by Robert Frost. So dear students, this is the first poem of your NCERT book English class 10. So here we go. So the title of the poem is Dust of Snow, and which is written by an American poet, Robert Frost. So before we proceed, I would like to tell you more about the poet. So dear students, Robert Lee Frost, he was born on March 26, 1874, and he died on January 29, 1963. And he was an American poet. Frost was the one writer who was honored frequently during his lifetime and is the only poet to receive 4 Pulitzer Prizes for poetry. I repeat, he is the only poet to receive 4 Pulitzer Prizes for poetry. Now students, we need to know that why Robert Frost has written this poem, The Dust of Snow. Robert Frost is a renowned poet who tries to change people's mindset through his numerous works of poetry. The poem shows how human judgment on specific issues can be misleading. There are certain animals, things, or objects that people associate with negativity and doom. So here, the poet tries to alter this mindset through the poem. So, dear students, as we know that Robert Frost has written a very short poem, The Dust of Snow. Indeed, it is a very short poem, but it has a very deep meaning. So here I go. I'll first read the poem for you. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rue. So dear students, I'll start with the first paragraph, first 4 lines. So here is the rhyme scheme. Crow is rhyming with snow and me is rhyming with tree. So that means the rhyme scheme of the first 4 line is A, B, A, B. So now I'll start with the explanation wherein crow, dust of snow and hemlock tree. They are 3 elements which are used by Robert Frost. The poem is set in a scene where the poet is in a bad mood and is walking by a tree. Which tree? A hemlock tree. Hemlock tree is a poisonous tree. As he passes by, a crow happens to throw some snow dust on him. Whether it falls on his head or shoulders, it is unknown to us because it is not clear in the poem. Also, the readers are left in doubt about the bird's specific actions. Whether the crow was landing, shivering with cold, or readjusting itself on the branch or taking off. It happened to some particles of snow upon the author. Here the 2 agents of nature, the hemlock tree and the crow, are signifiers of sadness and gloom, just like the poet's mood was in the opening scene. Now let's move to the second paragraph of the poem. I'll read the paragraph to tell you about the rhyme scheme. So second paragraph, which says that it has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. Heart is rhyming with bart and mood is rhyming with rued. So what is the rhyme scheme again? It is same as it was for the first paragraph. A, B, A, B. Now the explanation. For reasons unknown, the author was having a terrible day. It is not given in the poem that why he was sad. but the falling of the snow on his head lifted his mood instantly. He had already spent his day in a bad mood, but the rest of it was saved by the crow and the hemlock tree. Generally, hemlock tree and crow are used for negative references, students, but the poet used them beautifully to portray that inauspicious things in your life can bring joy and happiness too. One must not take things for granted and should be open and accept whichever way the nature chooses to bless us. So, dear students, before I take up the poetic devices used in this poem, I would like to specify that why these poetic devices are used in poems, why poets use them in their poems. So, answer is that these are used to make a poem more powerful. Poetic devices help the poet to decorate his poem, and these devices make the meaning of the poem more clearer. Now, we will take up poetic devices which are used in this poem. So, first poetic device which is used in this poem is alliteration. Alliteration means the occurrence of same letter or sound at the beginning of adjacent or closely connected words, like has given my heart. So here H word is repeated in the same line. H alphabet is repeated. Next example is and saved some part. So S is repeated here in the same line, connected words. Now, next poetic device which is used here is assonance. Assonance is the prominence of a vowel sound throughout a line is called assonance. Like in stanza 1, line 2, shook down, repetition of which vowel? O. Shook down on me. So, O sound is prominent here. So, this poetic device is called assonance. So, next poetic device which poet has used in this poem is enjambment. Enjambment means when the same sentence continues to the next line without the use of any punctuation marks like comma or full stop. It is called enjambment. It has been used throughout the poem. Now, the theme of the poem. First theme is that dust of snow has its main themes, like communication between nature and humans, nature healing and helping with negative human emotions, like poet was in a very sad mood when he was sitting under the hemlock tree and all of a sudden crow shook. So crow is a symbol of nature. Hemlock tree is again a symbol of nature. So all of a sudden crow shook some dust of snow and it fell on the poet, and ultimately it changed the mood of the poet from negative to positive. So that means the significance of small natural events in our lives also, like the small things. Dust of snow is a very, very small thing, and it entirely changed the mood of Robert Frost. Same way, sometimes even the small things in our life can change our mood from negative to positive. So, dear students, let's recapitulate the poem. Small things, what we have learned, that small things can bring a big change in your life, in our life rather. The message given by poet Robert Frost through the poem Dust of Snow is a positive change that can take place through negativity also, because negative symbols which are used by Robert Frost are crow, hemlock tree. So the little things can bring big change in life. So what was that little thing? The way crow shook the dust of snow on the poet who was sitting under hemlock tree, which was poisonous. So, dear students, simple act of kindness done can inspire others with enthusiasm and may bring a huge change in our lives. So, let's quickly recapitulate the poem now. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So, the way a crow, which is a negative symbol used by the poet, shook, which is a past form of shake, down on me. On me means poet. The dust of snow from where? Hemlock tree. So, the way crow shake or shook down the dust of snow from hemlock tree on poet, that brought a change in the life of poet. And poet, he has written that this act done by crow has given his heart a change of mood. Otherwise, when poet was sitting under the hemlock tree, he was sad initially. But when this happened, means crow fell. Crow shook a dust of snow on him. There was a drastic change in his mood. And that saved his some part. Means half of the day he spent in that gloom, in sadness. But rest of the part, rest part of the day he saved. And that was saved because of this small act of the crow.